All right, do you know someone who thinks they make the best food on the planet? Well, now they can put their skills to the test on the new MTV cooking competition show. Take a look.
The inside of my chicken is raw.
There's no possible way I need to eat this.
I was kind of like holding back tears.
I wouldn't serve that to my dog.
Please don't cry. Please don't cry.
You are cocky. I don't think you should be here.
It was awful.
Don't cry. Now is not a good time to cry.
Now is not a good time to cry because we're so happy with our next guest. Here with more on the show, House of Food, is one of its stars, Chef Brooke Williamson. Welcome to Arise 360.
Thank you.
All right, you brought drinks, so you're okay with me, girl.
But before we get to the drinks, you got to tell us more about the show. You're a judge and mentor on it, and it seems like it's a, real world meets Top Chef.
It's a little bit of everything. Okay. So it's not an elimination show, so these 8 students are coming to Los Angeles to learn from the 3 of us, and the goal is really to get them to where they need to be to get an internship, and one of the lucky winners gets an internship with all 3 of us.
And these chefs have no formal training?
No formal training. They're all, college kids, sort of young, but, have a passion for food, and that's where they're coming from.
Are you the Simon Cowell of the show, the Chef Gordon Ramsay? Where do you stand?
You know, the 3 of us are all very different personalities, and I think that we complemented each other's personalities very well.
Okay. What's yours, though?
I perhaps am a little bit more understanding because I come from a place where I didn't go to culinary school and I had a lot of great mentors in my life. So, I understand how important it is to have somebody that can lead you, with your career.
Well, I've seen the clips of the show and some of the critiques seem a little harsh. They're yelling at them. They're like, do this, do that. I can't believe you made that. What is that?
You only saw a few clips.
Okay. All right. So what are some of the challenges that they'll have to go through to become a winner?
They get given a different proficiency every single challenge. Mm-hmm. And, sometimes it's to learn how to cook a steak properly. And sometimes it's about presentation. Sometimes it's about working together as a team, which isn't always easy when you're not necessarily fond of who you're living with. So, it was a really fun journey to watch.
What do they win?
They win an apprenticeship in our restaurants.
Okay. What about the cash money?
It's not all about money.
It's an investment in their career, right?
Exactly. The money comes later.
All right, fair enough.
Now, why did you want to be a part of the show?
I just thought it was a really important dynamic to show. Coming from that background of not having gone to culinary school, I felt like it was something that wasn't represented on any other show, and I feel like it makes it a very different show.
Well, you mentioned other shows. Mm-hmm. How does this show differ from the other cooking shows that are out there?
Well, first and foremost, it's not an elimination show, and it's about teaching, and it's not about necessarily, there is judgment, but it's not all about the judgment. It's about, their journey and how they get from point A to point B.
And you were also on a cooking show, Top Chef Seattle.
I was,
So how did that experience help your career, and how was it? Was it fun?
Well, if you had asked me in the midst of it if it was fun, I might not have said it was fun per se. But
what would you have said?
All right.
It was difficult. It was really stressful. It was probably one of the most challenging things I've ever done.
Wow. But
why? What made it so hard?
I was put in a really foreign scenario with a lot of people that I didn't know, and I had no cushion to fall back on, and I was by myself, and being timed for the first time in my life, I wasn't used to cooking under a clock. Pressure is one thing. Cooking against time, against people that you don't know, and living with people you don't know, it's a really stressful situation. It's just as stressful as it looks like on TV.
What about your castmates? Were some of them a little catty?
We all seem to be a pretty mature group of people. There wasn't as much drama as some might have expected.
Okay.
Now, since you were already on that show, do you think that makes you a little bit more insympathetic to them or more sympathetic to them? It's like, you don't know what I went through.
I think it probably makes me a little bit more sympathetic. And I think that is reflected in the sense that, I understand how stressful such scenarios can be. And perhaps you know how to do something, but you can't do it under those time constraints. And, not everybody works the same way in the kitchen.
Now, when did you learn how to cook? Because are you self-taught? Did your mother teach you? Did your father teach you?
I learned a little from everyone that I was around my whole life, but I decided at a really young age, like 6 or 7, that I wanted to be a chef. So it happened over the course of several years, but very young years.
What were you making back then? Chocolate chip cookies? Pancakes?
Pancakes. Fruit flavored pancakes.
Yes.
And, even the shrinky dinks were exciting to me when I was a kid.
The shrinky dinks? Wow, you took me back. Yes, the 80s. I love it.
Well, now you're making more sophisticated meals. You have two restaurants with your husband, and you're opening a third one now.
I am.
Now, how's your third one going to be different from all the others?
Well, so Hudson House and The Triple are both sort of gastropubs, craft beer, elevated bar menus. The new place is going to be four concepts in one building.
Really? What's the name of the new place?
Playa Provisions.
Playa Provisions.
Yes.
Okay.
And we have a seafood restaurant with a big patio that will do brunch as well. We have a counter service, sort of upscale lunch cafe. We have a creamery with all house-made ice creams and push-ups and popsicles. And we have a whiskey bar.
Really?
Mm-hmm. All in one place.
All in one place.
Under one roof.
Yes.
So it's one-stop eating, not one-stop shopping.
Correct. You could spend the entire day there.
Wow. Mm. And when you're not there running the in and outs of everyday business, you're also doing mixologist-type stuff. And you brought a drink for us today.
I did. Ooh. So I create the cocktails for our cocktail list. And at Hudson House, this is actually one of our cocktails on the list. We work a lot with whiskey. My husband and I are both whiskey lovers, and hence the whiskey bar that's about to happen.
Right. Okay.
So this can be...
Whiskey's grown in popularity in recent years. Why do you think that is?
You know, I don't know why it ever left popularity.
That's an even better question, huh?
Right?
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just, like, it's a really... great all around, you know, it was used for medicinal purposes back in the day.
Oh,
so
really?
It makes sense.
So it's good for you.
Yeah,
you
exactly. So we're using Maker's Mark for this, but, you know, at the restaurant, we actually buy our own barrels of bourbon, and we have it bottled for us. And I'm using a little blood orange juice.
Blood orange juice.
Yeah, so these, you know, have the flavor of orange. They're a little bit lower in acid, so you get that really floral... orange flavor without the really bright acidity.
Mm. What's the name of this drink, by the way?
This is our bitter red.
Bitter red. Yeah. It definitely has the color. I see that.
Well, so the bitterness comes from chenar. So I'm going to pour a little bourbon in first. Chenar is an artichoke-based liqueur. And
an artichoke-based liqueur.
It's made from artichokes. An Italian sort of amaro that's made from artichokes. And it is very bitter, as you would maybe expect, since it's made from artichoke leaves.
Mm. Okay. How much were you pouring in of each of those?
So I'm doing like 2-to-1 whiskey to chenar.
Okay.
Chenar has sweetness, but it's also bitter, but it's kind of an overwhelming flavor. And then this adds a little bit of aromatic bitterness.
So it's extra bitter.
Some bitters in there.
Yeah, but it has the sweetness.
Just in case it wasn't bitter enough.
Well, you know, it has the sweetness and the floral notes, especially from this blood orange, to sort of battle those.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna add a little bit of ice to this and chill it. And then we'll just pour it in a little sort of coupe glass and garnish it with a cucumber.
Ooh.
And I use the cucumber to sort of add a bit of freshness to it. So you it's not necessarily meant to eat. You get the nose from that smell of the cucumber.
Very nice. Now, what do you enjoy
more? I love
more?
That sound.
Cooking? Oh, Lord, that's good stuff.
Yeah.
Do you enjoy cooking more or making drinks?
You know, cooking is my first passion.
Yeah.
But I feel like making cocktails and designing cocktails kind of is in that realm of creativity. So I enjoy them both, but, you know, I couldn't live without cooking.
There we go. So while we're pouring these drinks, tell us when and where we can catch the new show, House of Food.
The new show will be on MTV Monday nights at 10 o'clock, and it premieres March 31st.
March 31st.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Now you just throw the cucumber right in there.
Yeah, so you'll smell it when you take a sip. You can actually smell the aroma of the cucumber.
Wow, this smells strong.
Ooh.
I don't think I can handle this.
It is all liquor. There's a touch of juice in there, but it's basically like
a little touch of juice.
All right.
It's like a twist on an old fashioned.
Okay, well, we'll say cheers. We got cheers first.
Oh, cheers.
Cheers first. She's like a little sip.
A little excited.
We'll say cheers to you and cheers to the new show. Congratulations.
Thank you so
much. It's bitter, but it's good.
Right? It has some sweetness.
There you go.
This is nice.
All right. Well, drink up.
All right, Brooke.
And you're watching
Cheers.
Arise Entertainment 360.